Hello friends and welcome to Pendulum Edu. Today we'll be discussing daily current affairs of 25 June 2020. So quickly join the session and also ask your friends to join the session. We are about to start the session. Let's begin. And those who have not subscribed to our channel Pendulum Edu, please subscribe it and do not forget to press the bell icon to receive notification. Let's see what is the first news. Russia supported India for the permanent seat in the UN Security Council. Recently, Russia has supported India for a permanent seat in the UN Security Council, and it has said that India is a country that can bid for a permanent seat in the UN Security Council. It is capable of becoming a permanent member of the UN Security Council. Russia Foreign Minister Sergei Lavrov said this during a tripartite video conferencing meeting of the defense ministers of Russia, India, China, RIC. There are 5 permanent members and 10 non-permanent members in the UN Security Council. Comment quickly, who are the 5 permanent members of the UN Security Council? Yes, Russia, France, UK, US and China. Very good. Recently, India has been elected as a non-permanent member of the UN Security Council for 2 years and its terms will begin from 1st January 2021. Talking about UN Security Council, it is one of the 6 major organs of the United Nations. Its main function is to ensure international peace and security. It was established on 24 October 1945. The headquarters of the United Nations Security Council is located in New York, United States. And the 10 non-permanent members, out of this, 5 are elected every year for a term of 2 years. Moving to the question part, recently which country has supported India for permanent seat in the UN Security Council? Comment quickly the correct answer. Russia, Vietnam, USA and Italy. Yes, the correct answer for this is option A, that is Russia. Keep commenting the correct answer. I want answers from your side. The government of India will reduce their staff strength in Pakistan's High Commission by 50% in New Delhi. And at the same time, the Indian High Commission is also going to reduce the number of employees in its High Commission in Islamabad by 50% in the next 7 days. The decision has been taken due to the following reasons. First of all, the behavior of Pakistani officials working in the High Commission is not in accordance with the Vienna Treaty, the treaty which is related to, which is an international treaty related to diplomatic relations. And Pakistan's support to cross-border violence and terrorism and also abduction of 2 officials recently of the Indian High Commission at gunpoint in Pakistan. So these series of events have led to this decision. So as to ensure the safety of the staff working in commission in Pakistan as well as in India, the number of staff will be reduced by 50%. And talking about Vienna Treaty, it defines the standard for diplomatic relations between 2 independent countries. And the treaty was signed in 1961 and it came into effect from 24 April 1964. So a question can be asked that Vienna Treaty is related to which of the following? So it is related to diplomatic relations between the 2 independent countries. Moving to the question part, recently the government of India has decided to reduce the number of employees in the High Commission of Pakistan in New Delhi by how much percent? 20%, 30%, 40% and 50%. Comment quickly. What is the correct answer for this? Yes, the correct answer is option D, 50%. Next news is India will contribute $10 million to the United Nations Relief and Working Agency for Palestinian Refugees in the Near East in the coming 2 years. This decision was communicated by the Minister of State for External Affairs V. Muralidharan while addressing the virtual ministerial pledging conference. Also, India offers 250 annual scholarships to Palestinian youth and officials in addition to regular customized training programs. In addition, India is also sending a medical shipment to Palestine next week. And talking about United Nations Relief and Work Agency, it is an agency of the United Nations and it aims to support the work of relief and human development of Palestinian refugees in the Near East. The United Nations Relief and Work Agency, under the definition of refugee, covers Palestinians who were left homeless during the 1948 Palestine War. It was founded in December 1949 and its headquarters are located in Amman, Jordan. The current Commissioner General of the institution is Philip Lazzarini. Moving to the question part, in which year was the United Nations Relief and Work Agency established? 1945, 1956, 1950 and 1949. So, comment the correct answer. Yes, the correct answer for this is option D, that is 1949. And those who are mentioning the answer, good effort to all of them. Now, next news is Russia-India-China trilateral foreign minister level meeting concluded through video conferencing. And in this meeting, the External Affairs Minister of India, S. Jaishankar, participated and he emphasized the following things for the creation of a sustainable world order, like respect for international law, recognizing the legitimate interest of partners, supporting multilateralism and promoting common good. This was the 17th trilateral foreign ministerial meeting of Russia, India and China. And the last meeting, that is the 16th RIC foreign ministerial meeting, was held in Wuhan, China on 27 February 2019, and this was attended by the former External Affairs Minister of India, Sushma Swaraj. Now the question for you guys, recently which Russia-India-China trilateral foreign minister level meeting was held through video conferencing? 6th, 10th, 1st and 17th. What will be the correct answer? Comment quickly. Yes, the correct answer for this is option D, that this is the 17th meeting. So the next news is the UNHRC passed a resolution to ensure the safe return of Rohingyas to Myanmar, and 37 members voted in favor of the resolution in the 47-membered UNHRC, that is United Nations Human Rights Council. In this resolution, the United Nations Human Rights Council has pledged for the voluntary, safe, dignified and sustainable return of Rohingyas to Myanmar. The Rohingyas are Muslim minorities in Myanmar's Rakhine province. So a question can be asked that Rohingyas are related to which country, or they are the minorities in which country? So they are located in, they are primarily the minorities in Myanmar. UNHRC emphasized on the need to address the root cause of human rights violation and abuses against such ethnic minorities. The resolution has also praised Bangladesh for its humanitarian efforts to include Rohingyas refugees who fled from Myanmar due to violence and human rights violations. Talking about UNHRC, it is a body of United Nations. It aims to promote and protect human rights worldwide. It has 47 members which are elected for a term of 3 years, and it was founded on 15 March 2006. Its headquarters are located in Geneva, Switzerland. So you would have seen that many of the organizations have their headquarters in Geneva, Switzerland, as it is a very stable country and a small country. Moving to the question part, how many members does the United Nations Human Rights Council have? 102, 95, 47 and 83. What will be the correct answer? Comment quickly. Yes, the correct answer will be option C, that is 47. Keep answering, guys. The Golden Globe Award ceremony postponed till February next year. Recently, the Film and Television's annual Golden Globe Award ceremony has been postponed until February next year. Now, they will be distributed on 28 February 2021 and not on the first Sunday of January like every year. And the decision has been taken due to COVID-19 global pandemic. And talking about Golden Globe Award, these awards are given every year for outstanding work in the field of film and television. The awards were presented for the first time on 20 January 1944. These are provided by the Hollywood Foreign Press Association. So a question can be asked that Golden Globe Award are presented by which organization or which institution? So Hollywood Foreign Press Association presents Golden Globe Award every year. Moving to the question part, in which year were the Golden Globe Awards presented for the first time? Comment quickly. 1930, 1950, 1944 and 1965. What will be the correct answer? Yes, option C will be the correct answer, that is 1944. Moving to the next news, Indian Institute of Management Ahmedabad launched endowment fund, and this endowment fund has been launched with an initial commitment of rupees 100 crore from 10 founding alumni. The endowment aims to raise rupees 1000 crore over a period of 5 years. The financial health of the institution will be ensured through this fund, and the fund will play an important role in meeting the long-term goals of the institution and maintaining its autonomy. IIM Ahmedabad is the first management school in India to set such a benchmark and inspire other institutions. IIM Ahmedabad was established in 1961 and it is one of the dream school, or you can say dream management school, for many people who are preparing for CAT exam. They all want that they should get admitted to this IIM Ahmedabad and get a good package. Moving to the question part, recently which institute of management has launched endowment fund? Ahmedabad, Indore, Kolkata and Kozhikode. So comment quickly the correct answer. Yes, the correct answer will be option A, Ahmedabad. Keep commenting the correct answer, guys. If you have any doubt, you can ask that. Indian Institute of Science, Bangalore developed Nanozymes. So recently, Indian Institute of Science, that is IISc Bangalore, has developed Nanozymes. These Nanozymes can destroy the cell membrane of bacteria by directly targeting its phosphatides. Nanozymes are nanomaterials that can cause disease-causing bacteria to decompose a range of cell membranes. That is basically it ruptures the cell membrane of disease-causing bacteria. This study was recently published in the Journal of Applied Biometrics. This nanozymes has been found capable of destroying bacteria of typhoid, gastroenteritis, dysentery, cholera and pneumonia. It is believed that these nanozymes can replace antibiotics that have become ineffective, as many bacteria have developed resistance to them by producing their own enzymes. As we have seen that due to the overuse of antibiotics and availability of antibiotics without prescription also, so due to this many bacteria have developed resistance. They have become anti-resistant towards the antibiotics. Basically they have become resistant to antibiotics. And due to this, there have occurred many challenges. So these nanozymes can help replace those antibiotics and can be effective in fighting those bacteria and destroying them. Now moving to the question part. Recently, Indian Institute of Science, Bangalore has developed nanozymes. These nanozymes can destroy bacteria of which of these disease? Comment quickly, guys, the correct answer. Typhoid, gastroenteritis, dysentery, all of the above. What will be the correct answer? Yes, option D, that is all of the above. Moving to the next news. Ministry of Ayush asked for details of new drug being used by Patanjali Ayurved Limited as being useful for COVID-19. And we all know that recently Patanjali Ayurved Limited has made two medicines named Coronil and Swasari, which are said by Patanjali to be useful in the treatment of COVID-19, as these will be able to improve the immunity. Taking cognizance of this, Ministry of Ayush has asked Patanjali Ayurved Limited to provide the name of the medicine and the details related to substances used in making it as soon as possible. Also, the Ministry of Ayush has also asked the company for proof of research and testing of this drug. In addition, Clinical Trial Registry India has asked, that is CTRI, has asked to provide details of registration and results of the study. The ministry has also requested the Uttarakhand's government license issuing agency to provide copies of the license related to this drug and details of its approval. So basically they are asking for the details, the name of the medicine, the proof of research and testing of this drug, and also the details of registration and what were the results of study, and also Uttarakhand government's license issuing agency has been requested to provide the copies of the license related to the drug and details of its approval. Further, the concerned Ayurvedic drug manufacturing company has been informed to such that such advertisements of medicines, including Ayurvedic medicines, are regulated under the provisions of Drugs and Magic Remedies Offensive Advertisement Act 1954. So if they have to promote, or if they have to basically advertise their Ayurvedic medicines, that it then it will be regulated under the provisions of Drugs and Magic Remedies Offensive Advertisements Act of 1954. Now the question part. Recently Patanjali Ayurved Limited has developed which medicine for the treatment of COVID-19? Coronil, Swasari, Fabiflu, both A and B. So what will be the correct answer? Comment quickly. Yes, the correct answer will be option D, that is both A and B. And Fabiflu, recently Glenmark, it is a drug manufacturing company, and it has received the approval of DCGI, Drug Controller General of India, for the manufacturing of favipiravir. This is an antiviral and it will be sold, this drug will be sold under the name of Fabiflu. So Fabiflu was in news recently. Okay, moving to the next news. US President Donald Trump has banned H-1B visas till the end of this year, and this decision will be effective from 24 June. And this is a major setback for tech workers in India hoping to work in the US. And not only this H-1B visa, also H-4 visa, L visa, H-2B visa and J visa have also been banned till the end of the year. And Trump has taken this decision to protect American jobs during the pandemic, but has been criticized by the tech industry as well as politicians. Now we'll see which type of visas are issued to which type of holders. So H-1B visa is issued to technical workers. H-4 visa is issued to H-1B dependents, spouses, and L-1B visa is for intra-company transfer. H-2B visa is for non-agriculture workers. J-1 visa is for research scholars and professors, and J-2 visa is for the dependents of J-1. Okay, so these are the major visas and these are the holders. Moving to the question part, this is important. The question can be asked from this. So read this table. This is important. Now the question for you, which of the following is not correctly matched? H-1B visa for technical workers, H-4 visa for dependents of H-1B, L visa for non-agriculture workers and H-2B for intra-company transfer. Comment quickly the correct answer. You have to tell which is not correctly matched. Yes, the correct answer for this is option C, that is 3 and 4. These are not matched correctly, these are matched correctly. Moving to the next news, China asserted its authority over Japan's administered Senkaku Island. Recently, China has asserted its authority over the Senkaku Islands of Japan after a violent confrontation with India over the issues of Galwan Valley. And this Senkaku Island is a major disputed region between China, Japan and Taiwan. These Senkaku Islands are located in East China Sea. Okay, the island is a group of islands including Otsuri, Minamokojima, Kitakojima, known as Senkaku in Japan, and Diaoyu in China. Senkaku Island chain has been administered by Japan since 1972, but its legal status is still disputed. Recently, Japan passed a bill to rename the administrative region covering the disputed uninhabited island chain from Tonoshiro to Tonoshiro Senkaku, because there is a region Tonoshiro. So to avoid the confusion, this Senkaku has been named renamed as Tonoshiro Senkaku, so as to avoid confusion. But China has called this islands as underlying area and has warned Tokyo against any charge in the status quo. Although Japan says that since it has administrative authority over the island, so it has the autonomy to rename that island. The islands are 1,930 kilometer west of Tokyo. Over here you can see the location of Senkaku Island. So these are known as Senkaku in Japan and Diaoyu in China. And these are very close to Taiwan and are located in East China Sea. And both Japan and China claim ownership over these islands. And most important thing, that why it is a bone of contention between Japan and China, because the region, as you can see, the location, due to its location, it is strategically important. It is a strategically important place. And second thing, there are oil reserves. There are oil reserves in the region, and also it is a good fishing ground. So we can say it is also economically important. So economically as well as strategically, this region is very important. Therefore, both Japan and China claim ownership over the island, and its legal status is yet to be defined. Now the question part, the Senkaku Islands dispute is going on between which two countries? Comment quickly the correct answer. China and India, China and Japan, India and Japan, Japan and साउथ कोरिया. सो व्हाट विल बी द करेक्ट आंसर? यस, ऑप्शन बी, दैट इज चाइना एंड जापान. एंड बिटवीन इंडिया एंड चाइना विच इशू वॉज गोइंग ऑन? रिलेटेड टू गलवान वैली विच चाइना क्लेम्स एज इट्स ओन. एंड अदर पॉइंट वॉज पेंगोंग लेक वेयर द चाइनीज आर्मी एंटर्ड द रीजन ऑफ इंडिया नियर द पेंगोंग लेक. एंड अदर इज हॉट स्प्रिंग एरिया. देन अदर इज दोकलाम. सो दीज आर सम ऑफ द रीजन्स विच हैव बीन इन न्यूज फ्रॉम मेनी ईयर्स बिटवीन इंडिया एंड चाइना. दीज आर द बॉर्डर डिस्प्यूटेड रीजन्स बेसिकली. नाउ मूविंग टू द नेक्स्ट न्यूज. टू कंसेक्यूटिव एक्सप्लोजन्स इन माउंट मेरापी इंडोनेशिया रिसेंटली. टू इरप्शन अकर्ड इन माउंट मेरापी इंडोनेशियाज मोस्ट एक्टिव वोल्केनो एंड दीज एक्सप्लोजन अकर्ड ऑन 21st June 2020. And the eruptions caused grey ash to spread over some villages near Yogyakarta, Indonesia's cultural capital. The last eruption of Mount Merapi in 2010 killed more than 300 people. Indonesia is located on the Ring of Fire and a vast area around the Pacific Ocean. So, it is Ring of Fire is a region around Pacific Ocean and this region is very significant because many tectonic plates meet over here. Different tectonic plates meet in this region. So, it is a ring of fire because many volcanoes erupt in this region. Volcanoes, earthquakes. Okay. So, this is known as a ring of fire. And Indonesia is located on this ring of fire. It consists of 17,000 islands and about 130 volcanoes are located over here. Another important fact is that this Mount Merapi is one of the most active volcano in the world. It is one of the most active volcano in the world. So since this Mount Merapi is in news, so I would expect that there will be a question from this. So you have to remember this, keep revising. That this Mount Merapi is located in Indonesia and it is one of the most active volcanoes in the world. And in Indonesia, out of 130 active volcanoes, this is the most active volcano in Indonesia. Now the question part, Mount Merapi, which has recently had two consecutive explosions, is located in which country? Italy, Vietnam, Indonesia and Japan. Comment quickly the correct answer. Yes, the correct answer will be option C, that is Indonesia. So friends, here we have comprehensively covered current affairs and related questions. I hope you like this session and you are daily following this. Like the video, share it as much as you can. If you have any doubt, mention that in the comment box. And also you can read these current affairs from our website pendulumedu.com. You can also join us on our Telegram channel where study materials are available for your preparation. So keep preparing with us. And try to join more people to this session so that everyone can take benefit of this. And keep preparing well. All the best. Thank you so much.